Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be talking about how to do a burnout, but not only how to do a burnout, we're also going to check out the actual effects of performing a burnout on the rear tires of my Honda S2000. So first of all, what is the point of a burnout? And to understand this, it's kind of easy to look at extremes of tire temperatures. So if you have a really cold tire, it's going to be really hard, and as a result of being hard, its frictional coefficient with the ground is going to be low, and so it's not going to have much grip. Now if you heat up that tire, it's going to be warmer and it's going to be softer, and it's going to comply with that road surface better, and as a result have more grip. So in drag racing, you know, the launch is the most critical part. And so if you can warm those tires up before that initial launch and make sure you get a good start, then you're going to have, you know, more grip in order to accelerate quicker rather than just spin up the tires or have a lower acceleration rate. So the ultimate purpose for it is in drag racing, where, you know, one of the benefits, of course, is that it's going to heat up the tires and thus give you more grip. And it can also help shed off some debris or anything that's been stuck onto the tire so that you have a nice clean tire when you are starting that launched run. Now, the process in an automatic transmission vehicle is very straightforward. Literally, you mash the brake, and then you mash the accelerator, and you just let that rear tire spin. Often, it's that simple. Now, it can be a little tricky sometimes. It may not want to actually start spinning the tires, so you may need to use a little bit less brake pressure, get the tires spinning, and then once you have them spinning and you've got the engine revved up, you can apply more brake pressure to make sure your car isn't moving forward too quickly. And so, you know, that's the very simple process with an automatic. With a manual transmission, it's a little bit more tricky if you're trying to kind of just stand there with the rear tire smoking while the car isn't moving too much. And so to do this, what you want to do is push your clutch in, put it in first gear, apply some throttle, release the clutch very quickly, and immediately take that left foot from the clutch and press it hard on the brake. And so once you press it on the brake, you'll have those rear tires spinning, and you're going to modulate between your left foot and your right foot how much brake pressure and throttle you need in order to keep the burnout going. Now the tricky part here is knowing how much throttle you need to apply initially to get those rear tires to spin. In my Honda S2000, it seems to be around 5,000 RPM. That's kind of the sweet spot. You know, if you go much above that, you may end up just burning up your clutch. And if you go below that, you may just stall out the vehicle. And so, you know, you do want to find that happy medium, and it is kind of a learning process for each individual car based on how much grip you have and how much torque your engine is putting down. So vehicles with more engine torque, you know, big V8s, they're going to be at lower RPM than something like this S2000, which is going to be spinning up pretty high, but that's because it's a small engine and it doesn't have much torque. So now let's go ahead and watch a burnout happen, but first let's check out the rear tire temperatures.
Looking at the rear tires, both of them have temperatures around 15 degrees Celsius. Now for a short burnout. So, after two very short burnouts, you can see the tire temperature has raised to about 18 Celsius, with the inside of the tire at about 20 degrees as a result of the out-of-spec negative camber, and now once without brakes. The inside portion of the tire has raised to about 25 degrees, with the center at about 22. And because what you've probably been waiting for is a longer burnout, I handed the keys over to Braden Carlson, a fellow automotive YouTuber who happily dumped the clutch over 7,000 RPM while I filmed with the thermal camera. More power, smooth surface, and the clutch held just fine for a nice, long burnout. After the fact, the tires are roasting over 160 degrees Celsius. The tires do cool off fairly quickly, however. At 45 seconds after the burnout, the temperatures have dropped to 125 Celsius. By a minute, the left tire is just over 100 Celsius. At a minute and 45 seconds, we're down to about 90, and by 2 minutes, portions of the tire have dropped below 80. If you haven't yet watched my full video of the burnout using the thermal camera, I'd highly recommend it as it's fascinating to see. Also a shout out to Last Place Garage for letting us create clouds in their shop, and Braden Carlson for the epic burnout. I'll have links to everyone in the video description. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. Thanks for watching.